Welcome to Organization Access, the second in the Who Sees What series. These videos provide the basics on visibility and data access in Salesforce. One of the first things you'll need to do is give your users access to your Salesforce organization. By default, Salesforce does not restrict the hours that a user can log in or the locations from which they can log in. For increased security, you can set up a range of trusted IP addresses at the company level. Users logging in from outside this range are sent an activation code. They can access Salesforce once they've entered the code. You can also set up IP ranges at the profile level. If you specify IP ranges at the profile level, users logging in from outside that range will not be sent an activation code. They will simply be denied access. You can also specify the hours that users can access the org. Users who try to log in outside these hours will be denied access. If they are in the middle of a session, that session will be terminated. If you don't specify any hours, that grants users round-the-clock access to the org. Let's take a look at our practice org for AW Computing and set both the trusted IP range and login hours. We're going to set up our call center reps to only be able to log into Salesforce during standard business hours and from a restricted IP range. Then we'll set up our sales reps so they can log into Salesforce anytime from any IP address. First, let's check the company IP range. We'll find this in the setup pages under Security Controls, Network Access. We've already set up the trusted range of IP addresses at AW Computing for you. Anyone who logs in from outside this range will be sent an activation code. They can use this code to log in from their current location. This works, unless we further restrict IP ranges at the profile level. This is what we'll do for our call center reps. Call center reps should only be accessing Salesforce during standard business hours and only while they are in the office. We'll go to Manage Users, Profiles, and select the call center rep. In the System Settings area, we'll click Login IP Range. We will add the same IP range that was used for the company. By specifying the IP range here at the profile level, users with this profile trying to log in from outside this range will not be sent an activation code to log in. They will simply be denied access. Now we'll set up the login hours for our call center reps. Our call center reps can be in the system from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. on Monday, and the same hours for the rest of the week. Here's a tip. If you set the hours as 12 a.m. to 12 a.m., it effectively locks the users out. So we'll set Saturday and Sunday to 12 a.m. to 12 a.m. and click Save. Now we'll set up our sales reps. They need access to their data around the clock, from in the office or on the road. So we'll go back to Profiles and select the sales rep profile. Remember, login IP ranges are in the System Settings area. We won't set an IP range at the profile level. This means that if a sales rep logs in from an address outside the range we set for the company, they'll be sent an activation code, and they'll use that to log in. Now we'll set their login hours. We will also leave the login hours unchanged. This grants users access to the system around the clock. Good job! We've just granted access to the org to our users. For more information on the topic of visibility and access, please watch the rest of this video series. In addition, you can search for these topics in the Help and Training portal. Thanks for using Salesforce.